Tonight's story is somewhat unique and calls for a different kind of introduction.
I love you all. I thank you for your love and support around the world. I love my fans. You are my friends. You're very loyal to me. And thank you for everything you've done. And I'm working on something very special at the moment. God bless you. I love you. Bye-bye.
I was at the Comedy Store one night. Not the Comedy Store, but the Laugh Factory. Right. And I was performing one night, and this guy came up to me, and I thought he worked at the club, but it was this guy. He said, "My kid has cancer, and he loves you as a comedian, and he's having a benefit at the Laugh Factory, and he wants you to come and perform." And I said, "Okay, I'll try to come," and I'll try to come. Right. I came and met him. His name is Gavin, and he's a good, real good friend of mine. I love him to death. He said, he met me. He said, "Hey, Chris, how you doing? Thanks for coming." And he said, I know Michael Jackson." I was like, "Yeah, right, yeah, okay. How you doing? You feeling good?" He said, "All right, yeah, I know Michael Jackson." And I come and find out later he really did know Michael Jackson. He always used to talk about how he went to Neverland. I'm like, "When you gonna take me?" "Well, I want you to tell Michael I want to go too." So he used to tell Michael that, "Yeah, I know Chris Tucker," and he used to da da da. And finally, one day I was filming Rush Hour 2. I'll never forget this. I was in the middle of a scene, and Gavin's bad too. He's real bad, but I love him. But we were filming a scene, me and Jack, and Gavin runs on the set in the middle of the set, and he comes and he says, "Michael Jackson wants to speak to you on the phone." I said, "What?" He said, "Michael's on the phone." I said, "Break, cut. Jackie, do another stunt scene. I gotta go." So I went in the trailer, and Michael was on the phone, and Michael said, "I love you, and I love your work, and I want to meet you." And I was like, "I want to meet you too. I love you too. I love you, Chris. I love you too, Michael." So we finally hooked up. He said, "You come to New York," because he was working on his album. He said, "You come to New York," we hook up, and we got... So we finally met, and now it's all because of this kid, Gavin, and he's doing well now. He was, Michael was with him when he's doing chemotherapy and all that stuff, so now he's doing well. He doesn't have cancer anymore.
Oh, that's great. Good for you. That's great. That's a great story.
Well, when I first met the family, the accuser, he bragged about how Michael was his best friend and, all the things that they would do and their friendship that they had. And it seemed like a really great thing. And it seemed like something that really brought a lot of joy to his life. I never met the mom for a year. There were times when we would spend the night with the accuser in the hospital while he was undergoing chemotherapy, and the mother was never there.
For the accuser and his family.
I don't know how they sleep at night, knowing that they accuse someone who they called their friend and their family of the ugliest, most heinous things you can say about a human being. He's always known that Michael never touched him. Michael never abused him. And they told me that Michael was the one who helped cure this child of cancer.
Azja has only met Michael once at his trial, but Michael hosted her and Chris Tucker's son's birthday at Neverland. Azja says they spent a lot of time with the accuser and his family, lending their support during his cancer battle.
You know, someone who's watching this will say, "How do you know he didn't do anything? You only met him once. How do you know his character so well that you could actually defend him so strongly?"
I was present when these children were at Neverland. I spoke to these children several times a day when this was supposedly happening.
One night when Azja spent the night, she claims the kids were begging to stay in Michael's room even though he wasn't there.
And when I thought of what the accuser was saying Michael did, I thought to myself, what child would want to go into the room where these awful things were happening to them? I think that they feel like Michael should have done more for them.
Financially.
I love Michael Jackson. Yeah. That's a good friend of mine.